and said, burn it. Burn it, otherwise nobody's going to come attend your wedding. And he stood there and watched until I burnt it. And that was the end of my...
Did that scar you for life?
It didn't.
Obviously, he's writing now.
It didn't.
But
he also told me, pehle jilo, uske baad likhna.
Uske baad marlo, right? Yeah.
So,
live before you die, right?
Live before you write. Have some experience of the world around you and the motivations of character.
Maybe you didn't get your father right. When he said, live before you die, basically meant... you should live your life before I kill you. If you're going to do this.
I don't think my father was very democratic in his thoughts. So he wouldn't be the autocratic kind of person. But I sure as hell scared him. I did with that book of mine.
I don't think so. Your father was as democratic as you think. You little papa's girl.
Well, I am.
Yeah, see?
Every woman is a...
No.
Deep down is a father's.
And every boy is a mama's boy, deep down, yeah? That's what you like to sell to yourself.
It keeps the parents valid, you know? Relevant in that.
I don't think so.
How the society works.
I think society likes to put us in teams. I don't think so. I think a relationship can be like a more frank, friendly one, like the ones we share, rather than like everybody has to fit into that particular mold. I'm an unusual guy, and I don't look at things like that. I don't like to be in teams. I respect you, I love you, but I'm not going to be a mama's boy any which way. And I think there are a lot of people like that.
I think it is so confining I wouldn't like to be, you know, idolized or something like that.
Idolized. I was not going to say I worship you.